I missed out a few things in my introduction video for Boris Effects Samplitude, and one of them was about adding effects to multiple tracks at the same time. In this quick tip, I'll tell you all about creating submixes and how to bus multiple tracks together. And there is a way of adding effects and changing volume and doing all that sort of fun stuff we've already done to multiple tracks simultaneously. And that's by creating a submix or bus, you might call this. So I'm going to right click again in the gray down in the tracks area, and I'm going to add in a submix bus. Okay, so this is going to be our sound effect bus. And I want everything that is in sound effects 1 and sound effects 2 routed through this bus. How do I do that? I'm just going to come up to view and I'm going to look at the mixer, and we can control individual track volume by dragging these up and down. Let's just undo. You'll see that this matches what we already have set over in the music main, minus 12.1. And I'll just expand this out so we can see all of our tracks. And if we look down at the bottom, we can see the routing for these tracks. So sound effects 1 is currently going directly to the master. Sound effects 2, the same. If I click on this now, though, I get a chance to change this to the bus. Sound effects bus. I can do that the same way. Sound effects bus. So now this is going to the sound effects bus. This is going to the sound effects bus. And the sound effects bus is now going to the master. That's all we need to do. So anything that I do to this sound effects bus now, let's take the volume all the way down.
It's a great way to simplify.
That turns the volume all the way down on sound effects 1 and sound effects 2. Double click on that just to reset it. And this means I can also add effects to it. So if I want to add a bit of reverb, and I'll just type in reverb. Now I do love the 3D reverb, but you might not have it depending on which version of Samplitude you've got. So I'm just going to use the regular EFX reverb here. And let's make this big. Let's make this a large concert hall. And I'm just going to solo the sound effects bus. Look what happens. All the other tracks that are connected to it also get soloed. Nice. Let's make that last even longer. Let's make it even wetter. Oh, too good, too good. All right, and we'll do one more. We want the bassier bits on this. So I'll add one more effect. I'll just come back to an EQ again. Use the one we've already worked with before. Let's change this to the plugin dialog and a low pass filter going on. So we're just getting the bassier bits. Ooh. Yeah, there you go. That's nice. So we've got a little bit more whoosh in there. Let's turn off solo. Let's hear this in context.
It's a great way to simplify complex effects without any of the mess.
A little bit loud. Let's turn it down. Play it back.
It's a great way to simplify complex effects without any of the mess. Sapphire.
It's still a little bit loud. I'll allow it though. I think it's fine. It's there in the mix. I'm happy. If we need to, we can always change the order of any of these plugins as well. So if we want the dynamic equalizer to go before the reverb, we can always do that at any point. Again, non-destructive.
I use Submix buses all the time to make it easy to add effects or automate panning and volume in a fast and efficient way. You can even export out these buses to create stems for better versioning at a later time. And to see a full process of this, then check out the longer Getting Started tutorial linked in the description. And of course, feel free to ask any questions down in the comments.